All right, guys, so I'm very happy to be making today's video because Ready or Not is released on early access on Steam for $40 US. And this comes as a huge surprise because I don't think anyone was ready for this game to hit, I guess, the public in 2021. And this is mainly because Steam wouldn't give alpha keys to Ready or Not to sell via their website anymore. And so they pretty much had to come out and release the game as early access. Now, first off, this game has an overwhelming positive response on Steam, and it's like the number one top seller right now, which is pretty freaking stellar. It's a complete comeback story from what this game was, you know, like a year or two ago. Radio Silent, the PvP fiasco, it was absolutely messy. But now when they've released this co-op update, you can just see how many people are loving this game. So in this video, we're gonna be going through, is it worth it? What are my first impressions? Do I think there is enough content in this game? And a couple of tips and tricks for you new players to CQB tactical shooters. So first off, is Ready or Not worth it? There's a solid amount of guns in the game. There's about 6 maps with a couple of extra game modes, and each game mode has different map layouts and difficulty. So that alone helps with the replayability a lot until more content gets rolled out. There's single player with bots, which actually works pretty well because you can give them pretty much any command you would need to give players in a co-op session. And so playing solo is actually a pretty enjoyable experience. And the quality of everything so far, from the guns, the environment, the assets, the sounds, everything is stellar. Like, I play this game and sometimes when I'm playing the port map and it's raining and you got the lights shining off of everything, it's just absolutely gorgeous and it runs well. It's stunning how well this game runs and how beautiful it is, because really some of these maps here with the vibrant lighting are just gorgeous. So the next thing we're going to talk about is there enough content? And I think this is really going to depend on how you view Ready or Not, because if you are a CQB nerd and you want to learn how to do things, you know, semi-realistically, as much as a video game will allow, right? And you really want to learn the nuances of CQB and basically the tactics of working with a team in small units, I think you're really going to be able to get a lot out of Ready or Not, because you'll be able to improve iteration after iteration. If you're a casual and you want to go and run and gun through the maps and all you care about is like playing the next mission and you don't really care about replaying the same mission to do better, I think you're going to be a little bit underwhelmed with how much content there is in the game. I think the replayability in Ready or Not comes from finding a good group of guys, figuring out solid SOPs, and then trying to execute as quickly and efficiently as possible. And there's plenty of things that you can do after you've mastered that kind of verbal, I guess, break-in session with your team. You can then start doing time crunches, you can then start doing non-verbal runs. There's a ton of personal challenges that you can put on yourself to actually increase the difficulty artificially and give your team more of a challenge. Now, I personally have dumped hours upon hours into Ready or Not right now, and I view it more as like a simulator or training tool, and it's just been a ton of fun for me because I've been taking in a lot of real world knowledge from the people that I play with, because we've been able to play with some really awesome dudes, some Rangers, some Marines, and learn how they actually clear rooms and get to practice every single time, iteration after iteration, learning to do it better, learning to do it non-verbally, and just getting that good chemistry. And when that team runs like a charm, there's very few things out there like that. And that's like everything about this channel, right? Immersive tactical teamwork. Those are the three things that I really look for in any game, and Ready or Not has it. So if you're into CQB stuff like I am, I think that this game will provide you one of the most realistic CQB experiences. And so long as you're okay running iteration after iteration to improve, and that's like something that really excites you in an environment that has a decent amount of replayability and randomization, I think you'll find there's plenty to do. Another thing to remember is that this game is in early access. This isn't a full release, and I feel like we're just only scratching the surface of what this game will provide, and I'm really, really hopeful for its future. But that's pretty much my impression so far. This game has been amazing for me, and I truly feel like we're only scratching the surface of what this game will provide. I think that there's a lot of cool things that RON could end up doing that provides so much more replayability and dynamic situations, and I'm extremely hopeful for the future. And with my impressions out of the way, I think we'll jump now into my top 5 tips for Ready or Not players right now. The first tip here is going to be find like-minded players to play with. There are so many different ways to play Ready or Not. You have people who will play fast and rush every room solo. You have people who will meticulously plan and execute breaches on every single room. You just gotta find a group of people that match your vibe, that run at the same pace that you want to run, and have the same goals for what they want to get out of Ready or Not. Because there's a lot of different play styles out there, and you guys all know when you get like a Mil Simi style player running with an arcade style player, there's a lot of clashes there. So make sure you take the time to find the people who are on the same page as you, and you'll have a much, much better time rather than fighting your teammates every single step of the way. And because this is a Mil Sim channel, if you're looking for solid slow paced gameplay, you can always check my Discord at Discord. discord.gg/karmica and find some battle buddies over there. And also, playing consistently with the same guys will help you build chemistry and improve efficiency overall in the long term. And like I said before, when your team finally clicks and everyone is on the same page, there's no feeling like it. My second tip is to set up some SOPs, or standard operating procedures. Now, it doesn't really matter what they are so long as everyone is on the same page, but if everyone is working off the same sheet of music, things remain predictable and controlled, and in a CQB chaotic environment, that's extremely important so that your team can continue moving and flowing through situations without having wrenches thrown into the mix. Because this game will throw you curveballs left and right, but if your team is prepared and you guys know what to do in case of a scenario, you'll be able to continue flowing through that situation without yelling over each other in the middle of the gunfight. This can be as simple as saying we're always going to work right doors, we're always going to bang the room before we breach, we're going to C2 every locked door. Whatever you guys decide to make up, just make sure your SOPs are simple and easy to remember, and it's going to really help your gameplay. I'll eventually make the SOPs my group uses, but just standardize things and make the team predictable. This will decrease the odds of your players running off or friendly firing each other. My third tip is to slow down. Speed will come with practice and as you get more familiar with your teammates and your SOPs. If you start rushing into rooms, you'll end up getting isolated and exposed, and you'll end up getting shot in the side, and it just makes things so much more chaotic for your squad. Slowing things down and controlling angles are a huge part to CQB, and you'll learn that as you play iteration after iteration, and you'll be able to pick up that speed as your team once again learns those SOPs and flows through situations effortlessly because they know what to do. My fourth tip is to use all the tools at your disposal. Some maps aren't time sensitive, so don't forget to properly plan each room and use every tool before you make that breach. You've got door cams, flashbangs, riot shields, there's even CS gas and door stops and paintball guns. There's a ton of different things that you can use for working every situation. And slowing down using that third tip is going to allow you to take the time to think through the next situation and employ those tools. My fifth and final tip for new players to Ready or Not is create custom challenges for yourself. Eventually, you are going to run through all the maps. You're going to play a decent amount of the game pretty quickly here, and one of the things that you can do is start adding on small challenges. A really easy challenge to add on in the beginning is requiring all 5 operators to survive, and that's a really easy one because the second someone goes down, you just hit the restart button. Eventually, you can move on to other things like time crunches and setting custom timers that you have to complete the map in, and even non-verbal runs where you try to complete a map completely with your team without talking to each other, and that's a hard one. There's plenty of ways you can improve and extend the replayability of Ready or Not. You just have to find the right group and get on the same page. But that's pretty much my first impressions of Ready or Not at this point. I really think that this game has a ton of potential, and even in its state right now, if you're a CQB nerd, you're gonna find a lot of fun in this game. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and look forward to a ton of Ready or Not content on this channel. Make sure you subscribe, hit that bell button, and don't forget to check out the Discord at discord.gg/karmica, where you can find other like-minded players there. Thanks so much for watching, guys, and good hunting out there.